Welcome to your YouTube world. This is William Drosky here. It's like if you're new to my channel, I'm a certified cash flow specialist. I deal with credit education, financial services, with identity protection. I also provide services through since I'm partnered with Ameriplan, discounts on dental, vision, chiropractic care. So I own the website dumbexperts.com. I just wanted to come with you that I can share with a pretty interesting article that many people like are still drinking Coca-Cola there on a daily basis. And since that contains high fructose corn syrup, as from Life Extension website and magazine, like by Dana Flavin, you know, the metabolic danger of high fructose corn syrup. And it's like Americans every day are being poisoned by common additive present in a wide array of processed foods like soft drinks and salad dressings and commercially made cakes and cookies and also breakfast cereals and brand name breads. But this commonplace addictive additive scientifically increases our obesity risk of obesity, diabetes, hypertension, and other like health disorders and diseases. The name of this toxic substance is high fructose corn syrup. It is so like ambiguous and processed foods and overconsumed by the average American that many experts do believe our nation faces a prospect of an epidemic of metabolic disease in the near future. The related and significant degree to excess consumption of high fructose corn syrup. While like cardiovascular disease remains the number one killer in America, and scientists have noted that we are experiencing an epidemic of heart and kidney disease characterized by increasing rates of obesity, hypertension, and metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes, and kidney disease. Add to this list a disturbing rise of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And then you have public health crisis on enormous proportion. High dietary intake of fructose is problematic because fructose is metabolized differently from glucose. Like glucose is a simple sugar derived from a breakdown of carbohydrates. Glucose is a simple primary source of ready energy. Sucrose is table sugar, comprised of one molecule glucose and one molecule fructose. Thus, excessive intake also contributes to the ready rise of overall fructose consumption. Glucose can be metabolized and converted to ATP, which is readily burned for energy by cells in our body cells. Alternatively, glucose can be stored in the liver as a carbohydrate for later conversion to energy. Fructose, on the other hand, is more rapidly metabolized in the liver, flooding metabolic pathways and leading to increased triglycerides synthesis and fat storage in the liver. And then this can cause a rise in serum triglycerides in the liver and may lead to increased incidence of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And this is one like several links between high fructose corn syrup consumption and obesity, as well with metabolic syndrome. But like fructose linked with insulin resistance and diabetes. The high influx of fructose in the liver, the main organ capable of metabolizing this simple carbohydrate, disturbs glucose metabolism and uptake pathways, which leads to the metabolic disturbances that underlie the introduction of insulin resistance, a hallmark of type 2 diabetes. And in fact, effect of high fructose corn syrup on insulin resistance has been shown to have an impact on the prevalence of diabetes. In 2004, investigators conducted an ecological correlation study in which they compared the relationship between food consumption of refined carbohydrates and prevalence of type 2 diabetes in the United States from 1909 to 1997. They found during this period, the use of corn syrup sweeteners, which were almost non-existent at that time, during at the turn of the century, increased by 2,100% during the same period. The prevalence of diabetes skyrocketed. After controlling for the whole total energy intake from other foods such as fats and proteins, only the increase in corn syrup and the decrease in fiber intake correlated positively with the prevalence of type 2 diabetes. But an article by Aria Chanel. But before you can begin to think that this post doesn't apply to you because you don't consume high fructose corn syrup on a daily basis, but you want to get a few questions asked. Do you take high fructose ketchup? Do you use ketchup or use barbecue sauce? And what about Pop-Tarts? And as well with soda pop, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, Mountain Dew. Well, guess what? All those products do contain, are full of high fructose corn syrup. As a matter of fact, once you make the decision to remove high fructose corn syrup from your home, you'd be surprised how many items they have it. Processed foods are one of the ones that contain high fructose corn syrup. And it's not a natural substance, and it was created by a man, which is probably in a lab. And if you focus on eating natural foods that were created for us to eat, you don't have to worry about this substance. But as naturally occurring fructose and fruits, it's not a bad thing. But high fructose corn syrup is anything but natural. After all, it's been created in a lab. Because of this, the body does not recognize it and cannot properly digest it. Because high fructose corn syrup has led to so many diseases found in American culture today, including heart disease, cancer, inflammation, leaky gut, fatty liver disease, and diabetes, high cholesterol, and so much more. There's actually a whole list. And one of the side effects of high fructose corn syrup is inflammation, This deadly substance can lead to whole body inflammation, which is proven to increase the risk of diabetes, heart disease, obesity, and cancer. Also, there is a higher chance of triggering other inflammatory diseases such as gout. But you did not know that the research proves that more people are now consuming more than 500 calories per day of this sugar. This is about 300% more from 50 years ago. It's no wonder why 93 million Americans are fat and obese. Pretty much they're fatty boomba ladies here. But in the 3-week study that is found too much fructose and sugar led to a 20% percent increase of liver fat. Another study proved that high fructose caused more weight gain than other meals with the same amount of calories. And also this stuff contains mercury. This stuff contains mercury. And mercury is poisonous and can kill people when eaten in large amounts. But in 2009, researchers detected mercury 9 out of 20 samples of high fructose corn syrup. Short terms of mercury poisoning is nausea, chest pain, headaches, eye irritation, and vision problems. The long-term effects are just fatigue, loss of appetite, and forgetfulness, and anxiety. But the thing is profound, and it's such as much 570 micrograms of mercury have been found in each gram of high fructose corn syrup. That's more than half. Then taking into consideration that Americans consume 50 grams of high fructose corn syrup per day. High fructose corn syrup contaminated with mercury can be made from using toxic chemical catalysts that can burn a hole in your stomach. That was from Mike Adams from Health Ranger, which is an editor of naturalnews.com. That's pretty much the tags that, which is high fructose corn syrup, Matchell Norton News, is used as a sweetener in thousands of mainstream packages sold in the United States, around in the world, from bread to soda, and even breakfast cereal. This has been blamed for increasing the number of empty calories in the United States regular diet. And researchers have linked this to type 2 diabetes and obesity. Beyond the link of detrimental side effects such as danger from this ubiquitous ingredient comes from the toxic chemicals that are used to turn corn into cornstarch and then finally into high fructose corn syrup. One of the chemicals of this is Glutaraldehyde is pretty much neurotoxic. A toxic chemical used in industrial water treatment systems and to sterilize medical equipment by killing living cells. It also is a well-known embalming chemical. It's toxic to the human body and causes eye, nose, and lung irritation, such as asthma, sneezing, burning eyes. And this can even cause drowsiness and dizziness. This is according from the CDC.gov website. This chemical is so toxic that it can actually burn your whole, burn a hole in your stomach. As explained on this material safety data sheet, which is tedpellet.com, MDS, composed of Natural Nose News. In order to create high fructose corn syrup, enzymes must be added to corn syrup to change some of the glucose into another simple sugar called fructose. Enzymes, also known as alpha amylase and glucose amylase, used in the high fructose corn syrup processing, and have been genetically modified to improve their heat stability for production. So, if you think this stuff is healthy, and you want to go on a diet there and still thinking like drinking this stuff, but what the diet stands for is dumbest idea ever told. So, I would not recommend drinking Coca-Cola. As a matter of fact, this thing ends up foaming up. If you want to drink it, you can go right ahead there, but I'm certainly not. My name is William Drosky. If you like what I do, hit the share and subscribe to the button to be alerted by future videos. Or my name is William Drosky, and like I manage the website stomachstirrup.com, and you shake that money tree. Wish you all well and happy success.